What's not cool anymore? I think that was the only time I seriously laughed at a not joke, and it only worked because of how they built it up over the film to him finally using it properly after he failed to kidnap Pamela Anderson. I don't know why. I mean, I'm always up for a good prank, but I've never liked those channels that seem obviously fake, like those husband and wife things where they're constantly pranking each other. A lot of prank channels and prank videos seem very fake and staged, but if it's legit then it's pretty darn funny. I will say, as much as I absolutely loved most of the earlier seasons of the show, Impractical Jokers has worn out its welcome. They can't really do a lot of the light-hearted simple pranks that they did in the earlier seasons because they've been done before and also too many people would recognize them. Guitar Hero flooded the market with all of their spin-off games, 24 games released in 5 years and then one more 5 years later, and suffered from poor sales as a result. People want the game, but the various developers all shot themselves in the foot with an attempt at cash grabbing. The PS4/XP1 iterations of them fell stone flat for whatever reason. It's a losing battle to try to keep licensing up, and people generally don't play GH or RB for any original music they may have. My wife and I played RB13 fairly regularly and we didn't even bother picking up RB4. Music games that are made for arcades by Konami and Sega, among others, are still going strong. The 29th, well, 30th, iteration of Beatmania X just had its location test in Nagoya a few days ago. Ubisoft is still doing fairly well with Rocksmith as well, last I heard. It works better when they are actually trying. 5-0 be funny and original, becoming the originator of the meme rather than just altering what's already there and resharing. For some, they don't seem to understand that it's funny when an individual does that because they are a person. But when a company does that, people hold them to different standards. Man, I have friends in WA and when they first started complaining about the heat, I wrote it off as them being big babies. Oh WA, it's 95, so unbearable. It's 95 100 with 90% humidity most of the summer here, every year. Then I heard they don't have AC in most of their buildings, and that changed everything. Jesus. As someone from the southeast, I cannot imagine not having AC at home. It's literally required by state law here. You cannot rent out a home that doesn't have AC. The concept of just not having it is totally alien. I work for one of the biggest tech mechanical contractors in Seattle as a service coordinator. It's been brutal. The heat dome fucked us all up. We are exhausted. Our techs are exhausted. I never thought I'd say this, but I'm sick of the heat. Agreed. Getting older now. Recently bought a 20-pack of the same white t-shirt and 5 of the same blue jeans. Plain but easy. I guess some people might grow out of that. Unless you also mean edgy as trying hard to be different. Yeah, I don't have enough education on that topic to comment yet. Can be annoying. Can be because of society. I feel like there's some in between here that would be better clothes-wise. But if you like it, go for it. I'd recommend a pack of Hanes with multiple colors, maybe some tri-blends, and a pair or two of slim straight pants, not skinny jeans. Easy and cheap little way of looking acceptable to most people. Well, hey. That's cool. I think it's just what you are comfortable with in your own body. And I mean that. I don't really, really care what anybody says about my clothing as I choose them from the racks of flea markets or second-hand shops. I choose colorful and fitting IMO cool clothes and seriously don't put much effort into thinking about my clothing. They just kinda appear on me, if you catch my drift. I am not good looking. Nor do I dress cool to other people. Maybe you don't know, but I like them and that's the point. Just my thinking. You guys maybe have it different. People who think it's fun, cute or quirky most likely do not have whatever they think they have. ADHD is not fun, cute or quirky. It's annoying, challenging, and sometimes embarrassing because it makes you feel stupid even if you know you're not. People who don't have disorders can't tell the difference between normal or lazy behavior and disorders. If they really had it, they would know people do not find it cute once you're beyond childhood. You are the person they stay away from. Right, also OCD is more than just having to do things a certain way or having to check if something is locked 5 times. It can be obsessive thought patterns over many different things. From the perspective of the other person, it can be really draining because people with OCD can be very persistent and often need validation for things. It definitely causes frustration and anxiety. It's not easy for me, so I can imagine how hard it is to be the person with OCD and to deal with that constant back and forth in your head and the anxiety that comes with it. Edit: I don't know much about ADHD, but I'm sure there's lots of misconceptions there too, and you probably deal with similar issues. I can understand what you said about OCD. I was never technically OCD, but I had some low subclinical levels of OCD behavior. A lot of disorders overlap and can seem to present the same. Like, I sometimes have to check things multiple times, not because I'm OCD, but because I can't remember what I did seconds ago, especially if I'm doing multiple things at once or I'm distracted. Everything's a blur and it takes a lot of effort to just be present in the moment. As someone with ADHD, it can be frustrating as all hell. I don't forget things because I don't pay attention. It just literally slips out of my brain, as does my ability to track time. I'm not late to things because I don't care about them. I'm late to things because 10 minutes can feel the same as an hour to me, and if I'm not looking at a clock, I will not have any clue how much time has actually passed. My daughter started stimming for a while because it's somehow cool now to believe you have a disorder. I just told her to grow up. Oh, and her friend has Tourette's after never having any symptoms previously and will drop to the floor at random moments. A lot of people throw the term OCD around like it means this or that. Oh, I have to have everything neat and tidy, lol. I have OCD. Real OCD keeps you up at night. Thinking a thought over and over and over again is crippling. I had a 51-disc stereo when it was still kinda cool. Never really optimized the coolness factor, but it was a nice stereo. Was fun to put it on random and have it take 30 seconds between songs while it changed discs and spun around to a new one. Oh dang, this one definitely hit me where I live. Was helping my family do some house cleaning last year and we finally said goodbye to the JVC multi-CD stereo system that had been collecting dust in a back room. Think we bought it back in 95. And I hope it stays this way. 1970s home decor and fashion, including but not limited to harvest gold wallpaper, avocado refrigerators, shag carpeting, beaded lamps, fake wood paneling, flower print couches, polyester plaid, leisure suits, etc. Just let that shame be buried and never be resurrected again, please. Random humor. It may have flown in the early days of YouTube, but now I can't help but look at it with scorn. Like, I'm supposed to find some guy with a Donald Duck puppet screaming at the camera funny? Acting like a tough, superior know-it-all over COVID. No one thinks you're a hero fighting for freedom. Participate in your local health initiatives, get vaxxed and help end this godforsaken plague, please. Take my upvote, but when this same AskReddit question pops up in a year, you just know the leading answer is going to be being shitty with dumb anti-masking, anti-vaxxing, mouth-breathing morons. Old movies. Unfortunately, our reality has changed so much that now if you watch films from the 90s or the early 2000s, you will be surprised at what kind of atmosphere is present in them. Big corporations no longer want to take risks, and therefore a cool fragment of our culture was abandoned. And now, unfortunately, the films are not so cool anymore, and those in which a large number of experiments may not pay off at the box office, this is the only cool thing that is no longer cool because of money. I'm not sure exactly what you mean by this. I feel like over the last 5 to 10 years the overall quality of movies has decreased, like it's been a long time since I've seen a movie that I would legitimately consider a possible top 20 movie, yet this seemed to happen a lot more in the early 2000s. Part of it is because there's really no more middle ground movies, meaning movie that aren't huge blockbusters but not independent. It's like one of the other. It's either the Star Wars or the Marvel movies, or it's independent films which are usually decent but not great movies. There used to be a lot of really good movies that weren't huge blockbusters. Seabiscuit, Cinderella Man, to name two. So I don't think that movies from the 90s and 2000s aren't cool anymore. I will say one thing that has happened is that the emergence of really good CGI has made a lot of 90s and 2000s action movies look extremely dated and cheesy. I wrote rather that the old atmosphere of the films has undergone changes due to which the authors began to experiment less because of the producers and the fear that the film might not pay off. I also like the films that you have listed, but at the moment the cinema has undergone huge changes. At the moment, streaming services are capturing an increasing share of the audience and I am worried about the changes that will follow. I don't even remember the last time I saw a new movie I was genuinely interested in. Personally, I think the decline in the number of good new movies coming out can be contributed to trying to appeal to everyone. If your target audience is everyone, it's really no one. Yes, I understand the importance of representation, before anyone jumps on that. However, not everything needs to be for everyone. This comment deserves awards. It's so true. The ridiculous attempt at including and representing everyone means plot and story and movie come after checkboxes. It ruins the movie. Eat Rise of Skywalker, checked every demographic box and Star Wars box but forgot to make the movie any good. I miss movies where the characters looked like actual people. They used to cast folks with average, or even below average looks more often, and it made for a much more human experience. Modern films, the cast always looks like they were cloned in a lab for optimum aesthetic appeal. Hollywood equals all movies. I'd recommend checking out more independent or foreign films as there is still a lot of originality. Movies have now become a lot like music where it seems that most new stuff is crap but there is still really good stuff out there. You just now have to seek it out. The comedy style has definitely changed. Everyone is so sensitive about everything. They get offended by something and immediately have to cancel it. I agree that due to the fact that everyone is offended now, his feelings are insulted and so on, we have a kind of neutered industry. I'm going to have to disagree with the hoodie. A sub-$40 hoodie is going to be poor quality, fit like a trash bag, and almost certainly made in a factory where the conditions are hellish. I have two American Giant hoodies that are 3 and 5 years old and they're still in amazing shape. Only my black one shows its age in a bit of fading due to years and years of washing. Being an activist, it's turning into bullying for a good causes, and as everyone knows it doesn't work even if that's not everyone. It still won't work because few rotten apples make the whole basket undesirable. Edit, I need to clarify, I'm not saying being an activist is a bad thing. I'm an activist myself and a member of organization that advocate for a lot of good causes such as women, men rights, anti-racism etc. I'm just saying that I'm aware of how the bad or ones are the loudest and giving a bad image to the original good cause, and this can make people not feel safe around activists. I don't know if it's really considered a 90s thing or an early 2000s thing, but ripped jeans have come back in the young kids, which is weird because I remember that being really popular in the late 2000s when I was in high school and junior high, and I thought it would be a long time before that came back around, but all of a sudden it's popular again, and just like it was then, the ripped jeans look is god-awful. Yeah, the downvotes are from my fellow Gen Z kiddos, but I'm 23 and was raised by boomers, so I act like a millennial, sometimes dressed like one. Mullets, shorts, pedo stash, clunky sneakers, fanny packs, windbreaker-looking jackets, fuck all that. Apparently, being patriotic, I got my username when I was campaigning for Barack Obama. I get hammered for it all the time these days. I still believe in the US of A. I still believe we can be the best, if we try hard enough. I believe in my children. Guitar. It used to be cool. Then Brian May played God Save the Queen on top of Buckingham Palace and ruined it for all of us. And now all the best players are super nerds who have taken it to a point where complexity is more important than groove. Enjoying Blizzard products. Forget the Hong Kong stuff. Their games and PR have absolutely tanked. World of Warcraft was king of the world of videos and in the cultural zeitgeist for over a decade. Every game wished it could have been popular like WoW. It was untouchable. Overwatch 2 when it came out. Every game with a gun was suddenly compared to Overwatch. Granted, I haven't been hooked up to the video games of late, but now I barely hear anybody talk about either of these games, and when they do it isn't favorable. They're not dead by any means. But the domination they had over the video game landscape isn't even a shadow of what it was. Alternative music or music that has aged. Nowadays the only music people like is what's trending. They pay attention to those who are popular now and appreciate them in the moment only because everyone else is too. People nowadays are like, oh my god, Billie Eilish resonates with my feelings. Don't get me wrong, Billie Eilish is a talented artist, but it's just that other musicians exist too. I appreciate all music, but there are days that I'd rather hear Billy Joe Armstrong over Billie Eilish because I appreciate all types of music, even music that next to no one else appreciates anymore. Fidget spinners. A couple of years ago those things were every fucking where, even in gas stations. I remember constantly hearing kids beg their parents for one. I haven't heard fidget spinner at all for the past couple of years. They kinda just died. Punk culture's ethos. The punk ethos is primarily made up of beliefs such as nonconformity, anti-authoritarianism, anti-corporatism, a do-it-yourself ethic, anti-consumerist, anti-corporate greed, direct action and not selling out. Being bored or being disinterested in popular things. There is so much of everything, movies, music, TV. The internet makes finding out how to get into anything super easy. If you're bored, it's not because the world has nothing to offer, it's because you fail to explore the world. Don't like the popular stuff, that's not interesting. Put your energy into things you like rather than pretending the world around you isn't up to your standards. Why are these lumped together? I get smoking and vaping, but drinking, it's a social activity. It can be quite enjoyable, not keg stands and shotguns. And drugs? What drugs? Like depression meds? Or like heroin? Marijuana is quickly being regarded like alcohol and can be quite beneficial. Acting like a tough, superior know-it-all over COVID. No one thinks you're a hero fighting for freedom. Participate in your local health initiatives. Get vaxxed and help end this godforsaken plague, please. Take my up vote. But when this same AskReddit question pops up in a year, you just know the leading answer is going to be being shitty with dumb anti-masking anti-vaxxing mouth-breathing morons. Old movies. Unfortunately, our reality has changed so much that now if you watch films from the 90s or the early 2000s, You will be surprised at what kind of atmosphere is present in them. Big corporations no longer want to take risks, and therefore a cool fragment of our culture was abandoned. And now, unfortunately, the films are not so cool anymore, and those in which a large number of experiments may not pay off at the box office. This is the only cool thing that is no longer cool because of money.